Humayun's tomb is the tomb of the Mughal Emperor Humayun in Delhi. The tomb was commissioned by Humayun's first wife Haji Begum in 1570 AD. This tomb was designed by Mirza Ghiyas and his son Sayyid Muhammad. They were Persian architects chosen by her.
The mausoleum itself stands on a high white terrace platform with two bay deep vaulted cell on all four sides. It has an irregular octagon plan with four long sides and tempered edge. It is surrounded by a 42.5 meter high double dome clad with marble flanked by pillared kiosk, and the dome of the central chatris are adorned with glazed ceramic tiles. The middle of each side is deeply recessed by large arches vault with a series of smaller ones set into the facade. The interior is a large octagon. The octagonal plan is repeated on the second story. The structure is of dressed stone. Humayun's garden tomb is also called the dormitory of the Mughals, as in the cells are buried over 150 Mughal family members. Humayun's garden tomb is also called the dormitory of the Mughals, as in the cells are buried over 150 Mughals family members.
This was the first garden tomb on the Indian subcontinent, located in Nizamuddin East, Delhi, and also the first structure to use red sandstone at such a large scale. Humayun's tomb was declared a UNESCO World Heritage Site in 1993.
In 1997, on the 50th anniversary of India's independence, the Aga Khan Trust for Culture, AKTC, presented to India the gift of restoring the gardens of Humayun's tomb. The Aga Khan Trust for Culture, AKTC, completed the garden restoration. This revealed the design intentions of Mughal builders. For us, it is very important to go back to design intentions of Mughal builders. To do this, we need to go back to building traditions of the Mughals, where the craftsman was king. So lots of work carried out revolve around the stone masons, plaster, tile makers, stone carvers and carpenters to bring back the Mughal splendor here. The first objective was to hold further deterioration resulting from water seepage accelerated by earlier repairs. To prevent this, masons first filled the open stone joints on the double dome largest in India when built. A million kilos of concrete laid here in 20th century manually removed to restore original levels and slope. Masons rebuilt the portions of garden enclosure walls that were collapsed using original material, tools and techniques by the Mughal builders. The repair of facade by red-white contrast, each stone was inspected to define repair strategies. Stone carvers used their techniques and skills passed on from father to son over 3 million years. Conservation of vast sandstone terraces has restored original paving patterns and reset original levels to prevent further water seepage into the chambers below. Each of the stone block on the 4,000 square meter plinth weighed an average of 2,000 kilos and needed 15 more workers to lift it and reset. To restore a lost splendor, traditional hand tools have been used, reviewing an ancient craft and providing opportunities. These handcraft stones have replaced missing stones and lattice. Restoration of tiles on roof canopies using traditional techniques.